The murders shocked and horrified the entire city, resulting in one of the largest manhunts in the city of Chicago. For 2 days, the suspect, later identified as Richard Speck, eluded police by holding up in a seedy West Madison flophouse. Fearing that capture was imminent, Speck slashed his wrist and arm, allegedly attempting suicide. Police later discovered blood-stained papers and clothes in room 584 of the Star Hotel. Speck was taken to Cook County Hospital, where an alert doctor noticed the tattoo emblazoned on his arm that read, "Born to Raise Hell," a tattoo which had been described earlier to police by the only surviving nurse, Corazon Amaral. The morning after the murders, Amaral was able to tell police what the world would soon know.
When Chicagoans awoke that hot July morning, they received the horrible news that Richard Speck had killed 8 nurses in this apartment, taking them one by one from the bedroom, tying them with bed sheets, either strangling or stabbing them all. Only one nurse survived, Corazon Amaral. She hid under a bed and survived the entire ordeal. Later, to crawl out on this ledge and scream to the neighborhood, "They're all dead. All of my friends are dead. I'm the only one who's alive."
Without her identification and the description, chances are I would probably still be working on it.
Jack Walenda was the first detective on the scene after the murders were reported. Now retired, he still remembers the gruesome scene like it was yesterday.
It was a terrible scene. What made it so bad for me is that I knew 3 of the girls personally. And you walk in and you see something like this, it was a pretty good shock.
And what did you feel this morning when you heard the news that he had died?
Well, I was just happy that he's dead. Too bad the man didn't suffer more than he took the easy way out. But I think it's going to be a lot better for remaining members of the family so he don't have to suffer every year when that sucker came up for parole hearings.
The prosecutor, William Martin, called Speck a sociopath who killed without remorse.
To be able to come face to face with each victim and personally, either with a knife or his bare hands, extinguish the lives of absolutely harmless and innocent women who did nothing to him, it's hard to imagine more evil conduct.
Speck, who was 24 at the time, was found guilty and sentenced to die in the electric chair. But the Supreme Court overturned the death penalty.
There were hideous crimes. He murdered him in different ways. He strangled him. He knifed him. He did all kinds of things. And it just, it's unbelievable. And that for that, he should die. He should forfeit with his life. Remove him from society, shall we say.
Speck was later resentenced to serve 8 consecutive terms of 50 to 100 years in prison. A duration which for the family became an agonizing term as well.
And every time a parole hearing has come up, we've had just calls from people that we don't even know and asking, you know, if they could help sign petitions. And, you know, people have been really wonderful trying to keep him behind bars. And I don't know who would really let him out, but, you know, there's always a chance, so.
So then this morning when you heard the news,
well, I knew that we weren't going to have to go through that anymore, and we can kind of, you know, let it ride and not have it in our minds constantly brought up. And so it was a big relief. Something, of course, there's no remorse, and I feel like it's really happened a little bit late. I wish it could have happened sooner, so it would have saved a lot of grief and sort of torturing type thing every time it came up. And I think he's had a pretty good life and a pretty good ending, really, for what he has done. And I understand that, you know, he really didn't do very much, and he must have ate very well, because I understand that he has gained, like, a tremendous amount of weight. And so I think he was taken very good care of, which he really didn't deserve.
You think now this will allow you to get on with your life?
Definitely, definitely.
Speck appeared at his first parole hearing in 1976, but did not attend subsequent hearings. The surviving nurse, Corazon Amaral, returned to the Philippines. Robert Jordan, WGN News.